There are about 11 Illumination movies in total, not counting the new Minions movie and Mario movie coming.
Hello!
In total, that's about 17 hours, 6 minutes, and 1 second in runtime. Now, am I really about to spend countless hours re-watching these movies so I can rank them for your entertainment?
Yes.
For your own sake, I don't recommend that you try this at home. Here's your spoiler warning, which I'm pretty sure you don't care for. So for this video, I'm gonna be using this wheel picker to decide which movie I'm going to talk about first. Also, all of these rankings are my opinion, so go watch these movies and make your own. Don't attack me. Anyways, let's dive into the garbage. Please give me something good. Oh, okay, we're actually off to a good start. I'm telling you right now, this movie is probably the best Illumination movie ever made. It's not exactly as good as some big blockbuster Pixar movie, it's just kinda mediocre. Which also just kinda shows how ever since this movie, they've just been declining in quality. So, the story centers around a supervillain called Gru, adopting 3 orphan girls in order to steal the shrink ray from this guy called Vector because he wants to steal the moon. Since, you know, he's a villain, and that's what villains do. But in the end, he learns that being a bad guy is bad. I mean, what did you expect? And then he learns to love the girls, have a dance party ending, and that's pretty much the entire movie without mentioning the Minions. Now, I didn't have a big problem with the Minions in this movie. They were kind of just there to serve as a gag or a joke and didn't really do anything to add to the actual plot. These Minions are always the things I end up hating in the Despicable Me franchise, but more on that later. The movie sucked, but out of all the movies on this list, this one sucked the least. Therefore, it is S tier. Ah, great. Great. The Secret Life of Pets. So, back in 2016, I actually remember watching this movie and thinking it was alright. But now, re-watching it, it's literally just 1 hour of cute and funny pet videos with the most basic structured plot. Basically, this dog Max, who has the most copy and paste personality I've ever seen, gets jealous because his owner gets a new dog. Then they fight, which leads to them being captured by animal control. They then get rescued by this bunny, voiced by Kevin Hart, who seems to be in a gang of sorts. They then kill the snake, who was like the gang leader, I think, which upsets the entire gag and makes them go after Max and the other dog. There's also this female dog who's trying to find Max along with the help with like 100 different side characters. A lot of people say this movie was just a Toy Story ripoff, and I can kind of understand where they're coming from. The owner would resemble Andy, Max would be Woody, and this brown dog I forgot the name of would be Buzz.
To infinity and beyond!
But what bothers me is that this movie has no right to exist. The plot is so stupid and forgettable. There is nothing but unoriginality that stems from this movie. If you've seen Toy Story 1 and watched at least one funny cat video on the internet, then that's basically as good as watching this movie. B tier. Sing. Yay. I'm still
standing better than I am. This movie sucked.
Sing, from the perspective of the general public, may look like a harmless movie with funny talking animals. But I assure you that this movie is a bland, insulting piece of crap. If you're looking for something animated and has animals, just watch The Bad Guys, or Zootopia, or even BoJack Horseman.
That show is actually really good, go watch it.
For starters, the whole premise of Sing is that it's a singing contest with some plot in it. You know, I'm starting to see a pattern here. You see, Illumination has this awful business model where they just make movies off of something popular just for the sake of making money. Their most popular franchises are Despicable Me, Sing, and The Secret Life of Pets. And these all have something in common. Despicable Me has the Minions, which serve as the marketable part of the movie. Secret Life of Pets have funny pet videos with some side story. And Sing has the singing competition, which is the main gimmick. These movies weren't made for the intent of making a good movie. They were made to cash in on whatever hot trend was happening at the moment. Sing, by far, is the most insulting one of the movies. The plot of the movie goes a little something like this. It starts and we are introduced to one of the 8 main characters, who is this Koala guy. Koala guy is struggling to get his theater business off the ground. He then gets the idea to do a singing contest, wherein the winner receives $1,000! But while printing the flyers for it, his assistant accidentally puts more zeros at the end, making the grand prize $100,000 instead of $1,000. And because this guy is a compulsive liar, he doesn't even try to correct it. He just lies his way through. Eventually, it bites him in the back after this mouse guy, voiced by Family Man, gets found out by Russian mafia bears, and then the moment happens where they find out that he lied to them. Who could have seen that coming?
He lied!
And then the following action happens, where everyone's lives are practically ruined, but then they just somehow forgive the Koala guy in the span of like 2 minutes, and then they do the concert anyway because movie has to happen. I feel like the entire point of Sing was just to be as profitable and marketable as possible. I mean, I somehow ended up with a Sing Happy Meal toy. In short, this movie is a waste of space cash grab disguised as a musical. This movie gets an E tier. Actual garbage. Okay, whatever's next can't possibly be worse than Sing. Huh. Now, don't get me wrong, this movie was pretty goddamn awful. Probably worse than The Secret Life of Pets. When I saw this movie for the first time, it was probably when I realized that the only end goal of Illumination was just to make as much money as possible. And I mean, it kind of worked. We know that Despicable Me 4 and Minions Rise of Gru is coming.
Also, the fact that this movie grossed over $1 billion in the box office.
This movie was basically a prequel to the Despicable Me series, showing us how the Minions have evolved over the years and how they serve different bosses. Just don't look into who they serve from 1933 to 1945. Anyways, they become henchmen for the supervillain called Scarlet Overkill, who wants to steal the crown and rule England. But then the Minions accidentally betray her or something.
Don't you scarlet me, you backstabbing little traitors!
I honestly couldn't be bothered to pay attention. And then Gru just shows up and takes the crown. And the end. The plot honestly couldn't have been less dull, but oh my god, this movie is literally just 1 hour and 30 minutes of nonsensical Minion moments. It feels like this movie was just an excuse to produce more Minion funny moment compilation videos on YouTube. Like, Jesus Christ, this video is over 20 minutes long. That's like 1/4 of the entire movie focused on nothing but funny Minion memes. What's even more annoying to me is that after watching Minions, I can never eat bananas the same way again. Every time, I just remember the Minions and all the suffering I had to go through to make this video. Please make it stop. I also am fully confident that this movie takes the least amount of brain cells to comprehend. There's even a scene where the Minions hypnotize these guards and oh god, make it stop! The Minions' motives don't even make sense. Like, they go from looking for a new boss to somehow becoming the King of England for whatever reason. Not to mention how awfully inconsistent the animation is.
Oh my god, there's a lunchbox right there. That's absolutely crazy. And oh my god, it just disappeared! Oh my god!
Anyways, yeah, that's pretty much all there is to say. C tier. Huh. Okay, that movie actually wasn't that bad. The Grinch is one of the better movies of Illumination. I actually thought that this one was somewhat mediocre. The story revolves around how the Grinch wants to steal Christmas from everyone because he never got the chance to celebrate Christmas for himself. So he dresses up as Santa and makes these elaborate machines to steal presents. But then this girl traps him because she wants to prove that Santa is real. But then he just steals Christmas anyways and then feels bad for it, so he returns the presents and everyone just forgives him in the end. Believe it or not, there really isn't any comic relief Minion type characters in this movie. There also isn't much of a gimmick to this movie, which is probably why it didn't do as good in the box office compared to other movies like Despicable Me 3 or Sing. I don't really have any major complaints on this movie either, but if you want to watch a good hour and a half long animated Christmas movie, just watch The Polar Express. It's just so much better. Well, I mean, at least their advertising team was great. A tier. Oh great, another Despicable Me movie. Clap along if you feel like- Now, I think that a lot of people are going to disagree with me on this, but I think that this movie is just a tiny bit better than The Grinch. Listen, okay, hear me out. I feel like most of Illumination sequels fail and aren't as good as the original, but this movie is by far the most consistent one in quality, at least in my opinion. Yeah, unsubscribe all you want. Is it a good movie? Well, I mean, it's sort of just as mediocre as the first. But one thing I didn't really like about this movie is that there are way more Minion scenes in here compared to Despicable Me 1. These Minions don't really do anything that add to the plot. Sometimes the Minions would just be on screen just for the sake of, once again, making the haha funny moment compilation on YouTube. The plot consists of Gru joining this anti-villain league with his partner Lucy, and them trying to uncover the secret supervillain who pulled off the heist at the beginning of the movie. And as it turns out, this villain's called El Macho, and is planning to use Gru's Minions to rule the world, but then they stop him. And then the Minions sing YMCA because funny and hilarious. Honestly, this movie was pretty bland, but compared to The Grinch, I'd say that it's still a bit better. A tier. Welp. I got bras in Atlanta. Secret Life of Pets 2 is probably the most forgettable movie out of everything here. I actually remember going to the theaters to watch this movie in 2019, taking one step out of the building, and then completely forgetting everything that happened in the movie. I mean, I thought that the immense popularity and marketability of the first movie was enough for Illumination to quit while they were ahead, but nope, they went and made a sequel anyway. Alright, so here's an oversimplified version of the plot of this movie. Max and the other dog's owner are planning on going a trip, so then they go there. And then they meet this other dog who I know nothing about other than the fact that he's voiced by Harrison Ford. And then there's also a side plot where unnamed character number 1 teams up with unnamed character number 2 to rescue unnamed character number 3 from this Russian circus owner. And then there's this fight scene and holy sh**, he pulled out a gun. Oh, never mind, he got run over. So after the tragic passing of the Russian man, we cut back to the city and then the movie ends. Anyways, there's really nothing to say about anything in this movie. It had like 3 different plot lines at one point, but none of them were really that interesting. And after sitting through countless hours watching nothing but Illumination movies, every single one of them just blended together in my brain and I can't even begin to comprehend it. This movie's really nothing too special, so I'll give it a D tier. Yes, I know I'd rather watch Minions. It's all gonna be downhill from here. Hooray, another Despicable Me movie. Lucky me, I get to review another one of these. Honestly, after watching Minions, I completely lowered the expectation bar on this one. And to my surprise, it was still awful. Just not as awful as I thought. So let's start with the main plot of this movie. Gru and Lucy are fighting this new villain called Evil Brat who listens to 80s music and uses toys from the 80s to do heists. Which isn't that bad of an idea for a villain if it was just executed right. This villain had a really good premise behind it, but after the opening act, his gimmicks got kind of boring really quick. Anyways, so Gru gets fired from the anti-villain league he was working at because he fails to stop Evil Brat, and then gets informed that he has a twin brother named Gru. Gru then goes to meet Drew, and it turns out that Drew is super rich after inheriting all of the money from their dad who was a super villain. Anyways, they infiltrate Brat's lair and steal some diamond. And then, ooh, plot twist happens, and then everyone just gets kidnapped by Brat for some reason. And then the next second, he's terrorizing the city with a giant robot version of himself. Gru then stops him by beating him in the dance battle, and that's pretty much it. Other than the bad guy not being very interesting at times, the only other complaint I have with this movie is the goddamn filler. There are about three subplots happening in this movie at the same exact time. The first one being the main storyline with Gru, the other one about the minions going to prison for some reason, yeah, I don't really know either. And then the other storyline where Agnes is trying to find a unicorn. To give you a taste of how much filler there is in this movie, two of these subplots add literally nothing to the story. You can remove them from the movie, and it would still make sense when you watch it. And you have to understand that this takes up like half of the movie. Why is there so much filler? Why do the minions add literally nothing to the plot? It makes no sense. It's definitely not Illumination forcefully cramming these minions in the movie just for them to sell more. No, they would never do that. But Jesus Christ, this movie is a mess. Final opinion, it's better than The Secret Life of Pets, but isn't as good as The Grinch. B tier. Welp, how bad can it be? Am I right? Get it? Because that's the joke. How bad can I be? So, The Lorax is a movie adaptation of the famous children's book written by Dr. Seuss. Dr. Seuss. The book talks about the dangers of negligence to the environment and how this is all overshadowed by big corporations trying to make money. Now, this all seems like a great message to tell children until you realize that it's the same company responsible for goddamn minions. The whole point of The Lorax is lost when you watch this movie. It's like taking every single moral from the original book, shoving it into a poorly made animated film, and then taking a Fortnite dance in its grave. In fact, the message of the movie is so lost that in its ad campaign, one of the ads advertises a car.
Ironic.
Okay, but enough rambling. Let's dive into the forgettable plot in the movie. Here's an oversimplification of it all. Boy wants girl to like him. Girl tells boy to bring her tree, but tree no exist because company bad. Boy go to Wandsworth to ask for tree. Wandsworth tells boy long and drawn out origin story, even including a musical number which has been stuck in my head ever since I finished watching the movie. Anyway, Wandsworth gives boy seed for tree. Boy gives girl seed, and then they get chased by this guy who looks like Roderick from the Long Haul movie. There's also another musical number near the end, which I'm pretty sure got turned into an overused meme at some point. But then they let the seed grow, and then the end. Oh yeah, and I guess the Lorax was also there. He didn't really serve anything to the plot now that I think of it. Bottom line is, just watch the original Lorax. It's only like 30 minutes long, and is also available on YouTube for free. Anyways, as for the ranking, E tier. Oh god, not Sing 2. Oh god, not this movie. Let's cut to the chase. Sing 2 is complete trash. I can already hear the clicks of the several people unsubscribing. First off, no, this movie is not at all an improvement to the first piece of garbage. It's still the exact same brain dead movie, just for the second time. Here's the plot summary. Koala wants his theater to be more famous because I guess having a theater in the first place wasn't good enough. So then he assembles the crew, aside from the mouse. Unfortunately, after the events of the first movie, the mouse man was tragically eaten by the bear and died shortly after. May we get a moment of silence for the Family Guy mouse. Anyway, so they go to Vegas and then meet this wolf man, but as they were auditioning, they got rejected. And then the pig guy brought up this musician called Clay Calloway, who is apparently this guy who nobody has seen in the past 15 years. Now, knowing how impossible it would probably be to track and find this guy in 3 weeks, you would think that the koala guy learned from his mistakes of, you know, not lying. I mean, that was pretty much the entire point of the first movie, you know, to not lie. Nope. He lies again. There is literally no character development between the koala guy in this movie and the first movie. He just goes back to his old ways. So then a bunch of stuff happens, and then there's also this wolf daughter that's pretty goddamn annoying. Fast forward a few minutes and the giant wolfman is trying to kill the koala, but then he escapes. Clay Calloway is also here now. The porcupine girl somehow convinces him to join the show, and then they put on the show behind the wolf's back. And then the wolf shows up and then gets arrested. Good job, Illumination. You provided literally nothing new to the table. I honestly don't understand how Illumination can keep pulling off obvious cash grabs like these. They have the most one-sided character singing pop songs. Of course the movie's going to be a hit. I mean, I don't think that the song selections are bad in either movie, but in short, this movie is basically just the first one, except a lot worse. Don't watch it, F tier. Welp, that leaves this abomination for last. Hop is a movie that exists because some executive producer at Illumination somehow approved this.
Oh! What the fuck?
Honestly, this movie had no right existing in the first place anyway. It's just a mess from start to finish. Bear with me here. So the movie starts and we're introduced to this rabbit who is meant to be the Easter Bunny and his son. And then we cut to this guy called Fred who is a jobless disappointment to his family. Kind of like me. He then gets kicked out of his house, but then his sister gives him a mansion to take care of and also a job interview or something. I couldn't care less. Anyways, it turns out that the Easter Bunny's son is all grown up now. And he has practically no interest in carrying out the family legacy of, well, being an Easter Bunny because he wants to become a professional drummer. I mean, what can I say? The guy's got mad drumming skills. Anyways, he decides to run away and then meets Fred and then lives with him for a while. But oh no, his dad is sending out the pink berets, which are basically a royal guard. Oh yeah, and throughout this movie, there's also this annoying Hispanic chick that wants to be the Easter Bunny. Anyways, Fred goes to his job interview the next morning and doesn't get the job. And then his sister visits the mansion he's borrowing, and then there's just this really awkward scene where the Easter Bunny pretends to be a stuffed animal.
Look how cute this stuffed bunny is!
Wow. Yeah. Aww.
Anywho, then Fred has to attend his sister's play and then...
What is that dreadful sound?
But if you thought that was over, nope, it gets worse. Somehow the rabbit thinks that the pink beret has found him, so he jumps on the stage and then another musical number ensues.
You're being ridiculous, stop it, sit down.
Who wants to hear a song?
I honestly just ended up feeling bad for this poor girl. Her play got completely hijacked just for the sake of musical number has to happen. Anyways, I feel like I've been talking about this movie for all of eternity now. So let's just skip to the ending as all of the writers probably got sacked halfway through the movie. The Hispanic chick guy from the beginning kidnaps the Easter Bunny and then sort of becomes a bunny. Yeah, I know it's hard to explain, but bear with me here. The chick guy is about to take off in an Easter sleigh provided by chicks because common sense was completely thrown out the window when directing this movie. And then the bunny starts playing the drums, which causes the chicks to dance, distracting them and somehow saving the day. This movie is so unironically bad, I swear to God. And then Fred becomes a co-Easter Bunny because I don't know, okay, he just does for some reason. And then the movie ends with them flying off. Thank God the pain and suffering is finally over. G tier for getting the goddamn bin. It's over. All of the pain and torture I had to sit through can finally come to an end. Here is the finished tier list. In order, we have Despicable Me 1, mediocre. Despicable Me 2, still mediocre, but also there are more minions, so it's worse than Despicable Me 1. The Grinch, forgettable and stale. Despicable Me 3, good premise, bad execution, also too much filler. Secret Life of Pets 1, just watch Toy Story. Minions, god awful, please stay away from this. Well, unless you're 5, Secret Life of Pets 2. Forgettable and also complete garbage. The Lorax. Awful rendition, just watch the original. Sing 1. If you want to see animals singing pop songs with celebrity actors, then go for it. Sing 2. Basically just sing 1, but just worse. Hop.
Stay away from this movie at all costs.
If there's anything I've learned from watching every Illumination movie, it's that Illumination movies are practically the McDonald's equivalent of animated movies. But at the same time, I can't really blame them for making bad movies. They may have a terrible business model of just doing the bare minimum to pass off either mediocre movies or just straight up trash, but they make so much money through doing the least amount of work, which really goes to show that Illumination isn't messing around. They have one objective, and that's to try to be as marketable and profitable as possible. And honestly, if it means pumping out brain-dead movies like the Minions every now and then, I can sort of respect that. No, they're not good movies, but they're bringing a ton of cash. Capitalism at its finest. I already know I'm gonna get a ton of Sing fanboys trying to leak my IP in the comment section below. So please understand that, you know, these are all my opinions. Even though I spoiled most of the plots for these movies in the video, I still encourage you to watch some of them and form your own opinions. Now, if you don't mind, I'm late to my therapist appointment. It's been fun. See you guys in the next 2 months.